Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from my kitchen. It's Monday. Hello. I've been AWOL. I've been AWOL because I have been doing the new work-at-home gig, which is one of the most fun things I've ever done, ever. It's pieces of a bunch of stuff I've done over the last 25 years, all rolled into one hugely fun job. I love it. That's all I'll say. So I might be scarce from time to time, or sometimes for larger chunks of time. I don't know. But I still love making the snarzles, and I'm going to still make the snarzles. Okay. Today is a day where I should be going out shopping. But because of the at-home work stuff, I have laundry to do. I have fun to have. I have cleaning to do. I have more work home to do, and et cetera, et cetera. I don't feel like grocery shopping, and we need everything. We are out of cheese. We are out of all kinds of cleaning products. We're out of garbage bags. We're out of, what else, orange juice. But I don't feel like shopping today, and I'm not going to. Well, maybe later. So for lunch, what are we going to have? Well, we're kind of sandwiched out because for breakfast, Mom generally has her bagel or an English muffin, so I'm not going to make us more sandwiches for lunch. So what'd you make if you didn't have stuff to make sandwiches? You'd make a Rahmelett, of course, an omelet with ramen noodles. And then you would put peppers and onions in it and call it a Western Rahmelett. The only difference with this Western omelet, of a Western omelet, is going to be the ramen noodles and maybe a little spicing. But also, I want to try something I've wanted to try forever. Now that I've been doing all this souffle action and baked Alaska and such, I would like to, some people make their omelets, and I say omelet really loosely because the chefs would be pissed at me. You know, chefs say that cooking eggs, if you can't cook eggs, you can't be a chef. And I do not, I cook them for my taste, but I bet you anything I don't cook them the way a chef would. And for number one, because I don't like runny yolks. So this omelet is going to be cooked my way, not Julia Child's way or the chef's way, which they put their scramble in a pan and then they scramble it furiously throughout. So they don't really fold it. They're just sort of pushing it back and forth and letting the softness fall to the sides and cook to the pan and so forth. And then they sort of just go like that and slide it off onto your plate into what looks like folded, but it's not really sort of, it's like bunched up. Those of you who have seen it done know what I'm talking about. But I don't do that. I started young making omelets, and my way is to cover the bottom of the pan with your eggs, let it cook pretty much through, or even throw a lid on it to get it to cook through, because I don't like runny eggs, and I don't want my whites still runny and stuff. And then you put all your goodies in the middle, and then you, including cheese, always cheese, and then fold it over so that all the middle gets hot and melty. Today with my Rahmelett, I probably will, oh my god, I just squirted egg white everywhere. Don't get in my egg whites yolk, you're the last one to go. It's a 5-egg omelet. I figure if you're going to make an omelet, do it right. Don't do it big. Don't, you see I'm trying to save some of that white, but I got talking. I've started 7 sentences I've never finished. Now I'm trying to pull egg white out of my hand. Blech. I just squirted it everywhere. I used 5 eggs, but I was telling you something before that about omelets. I don't know. We'll see what I end up doing. How the heck do I ever know, right? You know that about me. I do have somewhat of a plan. Oh yeah, I started telling you about 3 minutes ago what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. I've often read that people like to make their egg whites fluffy like meringue first, you know? Whip your whites up first, then fold in your egg. You can see I'm trying to adjust my camera. I still have not embraced the tripod. I made you guys a video the other day of a horrendous potato salad I made. I'm telling you, it was horrendous. It was a 15-minute video of me making trying to make what I called stir-fry potato salad by using Kikkoman stir-fry flavoring packet and potatoes and a bunch of the ingredients that would be in a stir-fry. And then a lot of vinegar and soy sauce and a tiny bit of mayonnaise. It tasted delicious. It looked like vomit. It was so embarrassing. And so I thought, well, I'll still put it up so they can see my fails and my silliness and hear what I have to say. Oh, by the way, I'm using Worcestershire sauce and I'm using Frank's Red Hot to give it, you know, make it spicy. My friend Paul attached a video to my video, to my failed marshmallow video, telling me about a breakfast sandwich he made this morning, and it sounded so good, so that sort of inspired this. But I promised him also. He's giving me a list of things to make. If you people want a video response and tell me what to make, I can ignore you as good as I can ignore Paul. I will make some of them. You've given me recipes before. It'll take me a month of Sundays to get through them all. Now, what was I going to say? Where was I? I was back on this terrible-looking potato salad. So I uploaded it to YouTube, and YouTube rejected it. And I think they rejected it, I don't know, maybe the files from the camera that I have to use in order to use the tripod. But the camera that I have to use in order to use the tripod is not that good. And it's good for the food porn pics, and it's good for pictures and for videos out in my yard and stuff. But the light settings and stuff on it is terrible. And I don't know. Anyway, I'm back to the webcam for now until I can figure out what I'm going to do and make use of the lovely tripod that somebody I really like gave me. And I really like the tripod. But I'm not there yet. Oh my god, and I still have a computer. My mom got a new laptop for her birthday. I still got to help her set that up. And ugh. I got lots to do! Anyway, I uploaded the video. It got rejected. And I thought to myself, that is like divine intervention. I'm not putting that video up. Okay, here's my whites. I'm gonna try to whip them with a whisk without having to set up the whole blender. I told you when it's humid they tend to whip quick, but I'm not gonna make you wait for that part. I'll be right back and then we'll get to frying this thing. Hey everybody, I'm back, and just a heads up, Mom's outside on the back deck, so if you hear noise or talking or door slamming, it's her coming in. Sometimes she hears me talking and making the videos, and sometimes not. There's how we turned out, nice and fluffy. Let's see how, I whipped them till they got real fluffy, but not as stiff as if you were making meringue or something. And what's my plan? My plan with my ramlet is to do that. That's my ramlet plan. I cooked my ramen noodles so you'll see some chives in there maybe. I cooked it in the broth packet because I thought it would add flavor. I'm going to turn it down a little. I want to do this slow. I want it to come out nice and brown, but I don't want it to burn. Burned eggs are gross. Burned anything is gross. Here comes Mom. I'm going to get my serving plate ready, too. Hi, Mom. You're on camera. I mean, they can hear you. If you say something, sound intelligent. She's smiling at me and tiptoeing. She's so funny. I'm getting my serving plate. Okay. All right, there we go. We have that nice and spaced out and warming up. Here goes the egg. The fluffy whites sort of don't mix all the way in, but I don't care. Did any of you, am I like the last person on the planet who saw the honey badger video? A friend of mine in Germany tipped me off to it recently. Millions of people have seen that video. I just saw it 2 weeks ago. It's hilarious. If you haven't seen the honey badger video, go to YouTube. Well, that's where you are now, isn't it? And see it. It's so funny. Okay, I'm getting foam everywhere. That's all part of the... Looks like this pan is starting to stick a little too. It might be time for a new pan. I mean, I'm going to get a clean spatula. It's taken like every pot and pan in the house to make this omelet today. Doesn't that look great, the way it's all foamy and... It's going to be good. It's going to be really good. Now I'm going to get my... slide my peppers over. I'm going to... Again, because I don't want you to have to wait all day for me to get this thing, you know, to the foldable stage. I'll be right back. Hello, I'm back, and now I'm building my ramelet. This is all pretty much cooked, except the little yolk in the very center. That'll cook when I flip it over and the heat goes through, and if it doesn't, I'll shove a lid on it. It is sort of like a mixture between an omelet and a tortilla, really. Is it tortilla? What's the thing I made that Paul told me to make? The big egg thing you have to flip on a plate. Spanish tortilla, right? Okay. Is that a senior moment? Is that all right? I got a special thing I'm going to do at the end of this thing, too. Wait till you see. Swiss cheese, yes please. That'll just put a little quiche Lorraine flavor in there. Quiche Lorraine Western Romlet tortilla. And now I'm going to do the big flip for you, because you guys love my flips. You guys flip for my flips. Ready? I call it not beautiful, but not ugly. What do you think? Now we're going to get that cheese melted up and get the rest of that egg cooked in the center. Just gonna put it down on low. I'm gonna serve it, and when I serve it and you see it on the plate, you're gonna see this on it. I thought, wouldn't it be wonderful to have some hollandaise sauce? Well, I'm not gonna make hollandaise sauce. So I did this garlic dipping sauce from DiGiorno. They put it in their pizzas. We don't buy them, but my neighbor, my friend Annie, is the one who gets me the hot sauces from McDonald's all the time. Her daughter likes DiGiorno pizza, but she doesn't like the dipping sauces, so she gives them to me, and I put them in the freezer. This garlic stuff, yeah, it's a little, it's got a few, you know, chemicals in there. But for the most part, it tastes like butter and garlic and sauce. It's so yummy. Mom and I like to dip our own pizza. We buy Trader Joe pizza. Crusts into it. We had it with something else. Oh, we had it with shrimp. I made cocktail sauce, but I also put this on the table, so we had some of our shrimp with cocktail sauce and some of it with this stuff. So good. And I'm gonna drizzle that over my Western ramelet, and then it's lunchtime. I'll be back to tell you how yummy it is and with porn pics in one sec. Hello, please look at that perfection, would you? I've got the one hand cam. No, I didn't put it on the tripod. This is just food porn. You like I'm yelling at you? And I got my DiGiorno pack, so I'm ready. Look at this. It's like a Kraft commercial, isn't it? I should do fancy. Oops, I just slid that across the table. It made a mess. I should do fancy, you know, like the chefs do, drag my knife through it. So silly. Okay, you want to know how it tastes? Here I come. Oh my god, I love that sauce. Of course it would be yummier and better if I made it from scratch, but you don't always have the time or desire. That doesn't have much Western in it, but it does have sauce, and it has, oh my god, I didn't even take the food porn shots, and I'm already taking a bite. It doesn't have the veggies, but it has the ramen. Come on, you know already. It's an omelet with ramen noodles and vegetables and garlic sauce and oozing cheese out the front. So what do you think it tastes like? Good. Yummy. I want that pepper. Okay. I'm going to see you next time. Yes, I am, which is probably tomorrow. See you next time.